Surgical treatment of toxic goiter. What is the aim of surgical treatment? Either reduction or removal of overactive tissues. In primary toxic goiter and in secondary toxic goiter, usually we do operation called subtotal thyroidectomy. Removal of all the thyroid gland, leaving a very small part. Therefore, in primary and second toxic goiter, we reduce the overactive tissue by removal of most of the gland. Or complete removal of overactive tissue in case of solitary toxic nodule. In solitary toxic nodule, the solitary toxic nodule can be removed completely within hemithyroidectomy, total lobectomy with isthmusectomy, and we remove the all overactive tissue and rabbit cure. Also, it was found that after thyroidectomy, the thyroid stimulating antibody titer decreased markedly. Therefore, complete removal or reduction of overactive tissue with reduction of antibody stimulating hormones is very important. What are the indications of medical treatment? The indication of medical treatment is, first of all, severe primary toxic goiter. Compare here the first indication in medical treatment and the radioactive iodine and in surgery, primary toxic goiter. But notice that indication for medical treatment is mild primary toxic goiter. Mild symptoms easily controlled by medical treatment. But in mild or moderate, primary toxic goiter, radioactive iodine is indicated. In severe toxic goiter, surgery is indicated. Therefore, the first indication is primary toxic goiter, but according to the severity. In mild cases, medical, moderate cases, radioactive iodine, severe cases, indication for surgery. You should notice that most of the indication of surgery are the contraindications of medical treatment or radioactive iodine. In indication for surgery, secondary toxic goiter or solitary toxic nodule. Solitary toxic nodule is indication for radioactive iodine or surgical treatment. You can completely treat the condition in solitary toxic nodule either by radioactive iodine or surgery. Secondary toxic nodule surgery should be done. Why? Medical treatment leading to increase in the size of the already large goiter. And once you stop the drug, most probably recurrence of thyrotoxicosis occur. Therefore, secondary toxic goiter is contraindication for medical and contraindication for radioactive iodine. Why? Fibrosis in simple nodular goiter and secondary toxic goiter prevent the action of radioactive iodine and prevent destruction of overactive thyroid tissues. Also, there are three cases are contraindication for radioactive iodine and medical treatment because surgery should be done. In large goiter with marked pressure symptom, retrosternal goiter due to marked pressure symptom and severe disability in this patient, suspicious for malignancy. These indications, the operation should be done as soon as possible. Also, surgical treatment is sure indicated if there is failure of medical and the radioactive iodine. Surgery also should be done if there is side effect of medical treatment or the patient is unable to continue antithyroid drugs and the medical supervision. In this case, surgery should be done because we can't continue medical treatment. Pregnancy. In case of pregnancy, in the first trimester, we give the least dose of antithyroid drug during the first trimester. Medical treatment. The least dose, because surgery in first trimester is contraindicated because fear of abortion and the anesthesia may be teratogenic. But in second and third trimester, surgery can be done safely. Therefore, in case of pregnancy, medical treatment in the first trimester, second and third trimester, surgical treatment. You should consider all these indications and the contraindication for medical, radioactive iodine, and surgical for the solution of MCQ in case of cases, problem-based case. You should consider every point if there is problem solving and severe primary thyroid cause, sure surgical treatment. If there is mild thyroid cause, your solution is medical treatment. If there is retrosternal goiter, large goiter, pressure symptoms, suspicious for malignancy, inability to continue medical treatment, surgery is indicated. Therefore, take care during your study to know well every problem solving and how to detect the proper line of treatment according to the indication and the contraindication of medical radioactive iodine and surgery. What are the contraindication of surgery? Contraindication of surgery mostly or nearly all indication of medical treatment. If there is a simple, a small problem in this patient, surgery is not needed and surgery is contraindicated as mild primary toxic goiter, a small goiter, young age below 18 years. Why young age below 18? Young age below 18, you should consider medical treatment only. Why? There is contraindication for radioactive iodine in this age below 18 years because there is theoretical risk of carcinoma of thyroid later on or leukemia. And surgery is contraindication below 18 years. Why? The remaining cells of thyroid gland is overactive and they can repair the removed thyroid cells in surgery with high incidence of recurrence. Sure, surgery is not recommended at all in recurrent after surgery due to distortion of anatomy, adhesion, and difficult operation. Sure, refusal of surgery or patient unfit for surgery is contraindication for surgery. Recent true exophthalmos, there is a theoretical risk after surgery of production of exophthalmos producing antibodies, leading to increased exophthalmos. And we should consider that in recent true exophthalmos, only medical treatment is used until exophthalmos becomes stationary for 6 months, followed by either radioactive iodine or surgery according to the fitness for surgery. Therefore, most or nearly all these contraindications are the same as indication for surgery. And also, you can remember this by a small surgery, a small in symptoms, mild, small goiter, a small in age, below 18, or surgery, recurrence, refusal, unfit for surgery, or surgery also contraindicated in recent 2 weeks of service. Before operation, preoperative investigations and the preparation should be considered. The following investigation should be done before surgery. During surgery, the patient should be euthyroid. Therefore, just before surgery, thyroid profile should be done to ensure euthyroid state in this patient. If the patient is thyrotoxic and enters the operation, there is a disaster will be suspected, which is thyrotoxic crisis. Therefore, ensure euthyroid state by thyroid profile. And for medical legal purpose, serum calcium and brass hormone should be considered to avoid and to exclude silent hypoparathyroidism. And indirect laryngoscope to exclude silent vocal cord paralysis, which may be present in about 3% of population. Why serum calcium, brass hormone, and indirect laryngoscope for medical legal purpose? If hypoparathyroidism is discovered after thyroidectomy, or cord paralysis is discovered after thyroidectomy, there will be medical legal problem, and this is a responsibility for the surgeon, which produce removal of parathyroid or injury of recurrent laryngeal nerve leading to cord paralysis. Therefore, the patient should know before the operation if he has hypoparathyroidism or silent vocal cord paralysis, and write a consent according to this investigations. Sure, routine investigation before major surgery and before thyroidectomy as full blood picture, blood and urine analysis for diabetes mellitus, ECG to detect the cardiac condition and the heart is fit for anesthesia and surgery, chest X-ray to exclude any chest problem, ensure good liver function by liver function test, ensure renal function is good and fit for surgery by blood, urea, and serum creatinine. After these important investigations, you should put in your mind pre-operative preparation. And we said before that during operation, the patient should be euthyroid. And you consider the patient is euthyroid clinically by sleeping pulse. If sleeping pulse is 80 per minute, this is considered euthyroid state and the patient fit for surgery. Plus, thyroid profile, TSH, free T3 and T4, good. Therefore, this patient is fit for surgery. The preoperative preparation consists of routine method and rapid method, according to the severity of the condition. In severe thyrotoxicosis, routine method should be done. In mild thyrotoxicosis or moderate thyrotoxicosis, rapid method can be done. In routine method, usual medical treatment by propranolol and numerazole until the patient become euthyroid. Some surgeon add local iodine or iodides 10 days before the operation. Why? Because iodides or local iodine decrease the vascularity and the friability of the gland, render the gland more firm, and this facilitates surgery and prevent bleeding in the surgery. But this is rarely used nowadays. Some of the old surgeons like me recommending this condition. Iodides or local iodine 10 days before operation to decrease vascularity, friability of the gland, and the gland becomes more firmer and easily handled during the operation. The disadvantage of the routine method is long duration. This takes about few weeks to prepare the patient. In mild cases, rapid method can be done only by propranolol. Propranolol is given for 1 week before the operation and 1 week after the operation. The aim, control of cardiovascular manifestation. If the heart returns to the normal, the patient becomes fit for surgery. During operation for thyroidectomy, the following point should be done and should be considered. First of all, the incision should be wide with division of pretracheal muscles. Why? So that the field of the operation becomes wide. And do the operation with minimal manipulation, because rough manipulation for thyrotoxicosis may precipitate thyrotoxic crisis, which may be fatal. Second, the usual operation done for thyrotoxicosis is subtotal thyroidectomy, in which we leave all the gland, we remove all the gland, leaving only 4 to 5 grams on each side of thyroid tissue on the posteromedial aspect. Why to leave this posteromedial part on each lobe? To preserve and to ensure preservation of recurrent laryngeal nerve and the parathyroids. And the remaining part maintain the euthyroid state after the operation. We should notice that inexperienced surgeons may recommend total thyroidectomy followed by L-thyroxine for life. Sure, L-thyroxine for life before we remove the thyroid gland. Why remove total thyroidectomy? To ensure no recurrence, to avoid recurrence of toxicity. And in experienced hand, no fear for removal of parathyroids or injury of recurrent laryngeal nerve. Finally, perfect hemostasis and drain should be done. Why? If the gland is highly vascular, if you leave a small bleeding vessel, hematoma may occur. And why drain? If there is any ooze of thyroid hormones, it will be sucked outside the body. Because if thyroid hormones are well not drained, absorption of these thyroid hormones into the circulation leading to thyrotoxic crisis. What is the importance for and advantage for surgery? Surgery avoids prolonged medical treatment and avoids the hazards of radioactive iodine. And surgery means rapid cure with very, very high rate of success. What is the complications of surgery? First of all, morbidity and mortality can be neglected in experienced hand. Post-operative complication of thyroidectomy, which is rare in experienced hand, First of all, injury of important surround structure, especially surrounding nerves. Injury of recurrent laryngeal nerve, external laryngeal nerve, or rarely injury of internal laryngeal nerve. Injury of parathyroids leading to parathyroid insufficiency may occur in about 0.5% of cases. Respiratory obstruction after thyroidectomy may be due to bilateral incomplete recurrent laryngeal nerve injury. Because in bilateral incomplete recurrent laryngeal nerve injury, this leads to spasm of the vocal cord with closure of the inlet of the larynx. Or compression of the trachea by hematoma. Or due to rough manipulation around the trachea and the larynx may lead to laryngeal edema. Or trauma by endotracheal tube. And finally, tracheomalacia. Sure, if respiratory obstruction occurs as emergency, endotracheal tube is recommended. And in prolonged indication, tracheostomy is done. If you remove excessive thyroid tissue, hypothyroidism is the rule. If you don't remove proper thyroid tissue, recurrence is the rule. As any operation, hemorrhage may occur, which may be primary, reactionary, or secondary. Wound infection may lead to subcutaneous abscess or deep cervical abscess. Keloid may occur in the wound as a delayed wound complication. And the most serious problem, if the patient is not well prepared, thyrotoxic crisis may occur. And sure, thyrotoxic crisis is very rare nowadays because, as a rule, the patient never enters the theater without very good, perfect preparation, and the patient during the operation should be euthyroid. This is the surgical treatment of thyrotoxicosis. Thank you for good listening.